That's a good story. And you didn't know about that story until I told you like a few weeks ago. That's
right.
It.
We were driving up for the Yamaha e-bike intro.
Yeah.
And you used to work with a guy that was a Vietnam vet.
No, I worked at Al Baker's XRs only.
Yeah.
And that was on the airport, Hesperia Airport Strip. So Vietnam Vic lived at the airport.
Okay.
That's why.
So he worked at the airport.
He just had a hangar, had a plane. That's where he liked to live. And
okay,
he'd
so
fly from there.
He'd come up by and...
Yeah, so you want me to tell a story?
Yeah.
Okay. So I worked there as a shipper, Al Baker's XRs only. He'd come in every day. Yep. He wants to bullshit with everybody. He's an old Vietnam vet, and his name was Vietnam Vic. That's what we called him. And we'd sit there and bullshit. And he would ask me all the time, do you want to go fly with me? And I would say, no, no, no. And he was just a... You could picture Vietnam Vic, gray hair, skinny guy, just has some old tattoos on his arm. And
saw some shit.
He saw some shit, right?
Yeah.
And finally, I was just tired of saying no to him because he would bust my balls. And I said, you know what, Vic? I'll go up with you. So I decided to go with him. He had like, and I'm not a plane guy. I don't know, so excuse me. But like a little stunt plane.
Yeah.
And he was in the front. I was in the back and had a headset on. And we went up and everything was fine for about, you know, 3-4 minutes. And all I remember is this voice is embedded in my brain and just burned into it. And he would be like, okay, we're going to come down. And I'd be like, huh? And I'm like, what, Vic? He's, okay, you hear me? Okay, brother. And I'm like, fuck, I don't know what this guy's saying. And he would go, all right, are you ready back there? And I'm like, excuse me? And as soon as I would say excuse me, he'd go, meow. And
he'd go head up.
He'd go straight up.
Right. But he was asking you if you're okay.
Yeah, and he would ask me. I feel like he was asking me questions, and then he would go straight up and then did a stall and came back. And we'd buzz the fucking meow by the strip, airstrip. And he'd be like, you okay back there? And I'd be like, oh, man, that was gnarly. And he's like, okay, we're talking about it. I wouldn't even get my sentence out, and he's already talking to me. And I don't know how the mics work. I thought only one person could talk, but for some reason he would talk right over me. And I'm going to try something else. And I'm like, hey, Vic, I don't know. I'm kind of getting, okay, we're going to try it. And he fucking, yeah, double loop. How's that? Was that okay back there? And I'm like, hey, Vic. Okay, we're going to try one more. Then. And then he did his other one. We flew upside down. And that's all I remember in my fucking head. Is, okay back there? Every fucking time.
But you threw up.
I threw up, and there's shit all over me. And I get back to the guy. Yeah, that was fun. You okay back there? And I'm like, Vic, I threw up. Yeah, that was fun. I'm like, Jesus, dude. I get out of the plane, and for the rest of the fucking
Vietnam
day,
Vietnam Vic
gave zero fucks, dude. You okay back there? That's all I fucking heard all day. And then I get off the plane. There's fucking throw up all over me. And he's like, "Was that fun, Mike?" And I go, "No, Vic, I didn't have a good time. I was sick." And he's like, "Well, you didn't tell me." I go, "Yes, I did. I did tell you, Vic." And every time after that, he would come in and he still asked me, "Do you want to go up?" And I go, "Fuck no, I'm not going up anymore." And so to this day, that voice is in my head. 25 years later.
As soon as he said that, he put into a dive or go straight up.
I didn't even get halfway to my sentence. Here's
you okay back there?
No.
Okay, we're going to try that.
I'm just like, fuck you, Vic. And I couldn't say shit. I was sick.
Just throw up everywhere.
The rest of the day, I had to finish the job, my shipping duties, and I was sick for the rest of the day. I had no change of clothes. I had to put a jersey on to ship shit. I was like, I was a mess. Vic fucked me up.
You okay back there?
No, Vic, I'm not.
No, Vic. Things are not well.
Not
back
good,
here.
Vic.
Right. Oh, fuck. That's a good one. All right. From Vietnam, Vic, let's go right into our next guest here on the show.